What's up, you guys? I'm Shamika Sanders, and I'm here with the lovely Brandi Victorian and Kiara Kelly. And you're watching Listen to Black Women. On this show, we will discuss topics and issues that affect us the most. So, per usual, let's get into it, ladies.
So, earlier this year, Ciara had the internet mad because she posted a video from a sermon from John Gray where he was talking about there's too many women out here who want to be wives but are walking around with the spirit of girlfriend.
Oh, he tried it.
Yes. And Ciara, now that she's a wife, had decided that her best response to that was level up. Mm. That was her hashtag. Oh. Let's watch the clip.
Too many women want to be married, but you're walking in the spirit of girlfriend. Ask the Lord to deliver you from that spirit and carry yourself like you're already taken. And I promise you, when you carry yourself like a wife, a husband will find you.
So, as y'all can imagine, the internet was in an uproar over that mess. Because they were like, level up. Like, girl, weren't you just a baby mama a couple years ago?
Talk about it.
So, people were not pleased. And they criticized both Ciara and John Gray. Mm-hmm. And I actually had the opportunity to sit down and talk to John Gray, who wanted to make it clear that that sermon was not for all women. It was specifically for Christian women. Mm-hmm. But we're going to get into that a little bit later.
Okay. So.
All of this leads to the question of the week. Mm-hmm. What the hell is the spirit of girlfriend? Let's see what social media had to say. Each week we scoured the internet for comments, tweets, and Instagrams to see what you have to say about these topics. This week we are talking about the idea of a woman not being whole until she becomes married. Thank you, Pastor Gray! One tweet said, "She's using her marriage as a weapon. You're no better than me. My worth is not tied to my marital status." Well, come on, girlfriend, because I agree with you.
Yes.
A weapon?
I agree.
Why a weapon?
Because, you know, people use this ring like to shame other women.
Oh.
I got chose, you didn't get chose, you mm-hmm. won't get chose.
It's so true. Why would people be against this? Carry yourself with respect, confidence, and grace, and you will be treated as such. Carry yourself with apathy and pridefulness, you will be treated as such. Your character will define the people you attract. Well, the spirit of girlfriend lives in you, doesn't it?
That's the spirit of a wife right there.
Oh, level up.
And I think that's a lie. I mean, there's no guarantee of any of those things. And you're also implying that women who are single don't have grace. What was it? Confidence?
Apathy?
Respect? Forgiveness?
No, that's the single girls. Single girls are apathetic.
Oh, okay.
Grace, you're forgiveness,
grace. Mm-hmm.
All those things, which isn't
it's
true.
It's just not that simple.
No. Yeah.
Bevy Smith tweeted, come on, bring it home for us, Bevy.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of debating whether we have a spirit of wife or a spirit of girlfriend, can we get our spirit as a human together? Come on.
Nice.
Too many women allow society to convince them to find themselves in a relationship and outside of themselves. That's why so many women end up in bad relationships and stay.
Yes, snaps for Bevy
Come on, Bevy.
Keeping it real, because too many women out here not investing in themselves and just looking to be someone on someone else's arm.
Exactly.
And if you don't have yourself right, that relationship isn't going to flourish and you ain't going to flourish. So mm-hmm. Bevy had it.
Kiara, what did the readers on Hello Beautiful and Madame Noir have to say about this topic?
We asked our Madame Noir and Hello Beautiful readers, what does a woman have to change about herself to really embody the spirit of wife? Mm. Y'all ready to find out what the readers had to say?
Yes.
Dying to know.
Let's get into the receipts. So we asked, what is the most important quality a woman should have to attract a godly man?
Okay,
a godly man. And 62% of you said a relationship with God is the most important.
Okay.
Agreed.
Agreed.
29% of you said pursuing her divine purpose is the second most important quality.
You know, okay.
What?
You messed them up there. You know why? Because you put divine.
Mm.
The wording, divine is so close to God, so they was going to choose that next. They were like, how do I just emphasize God?
Because it's my divine purpose to be a wife.
Yes.
Okay, all right. So if I had just put career goals, they would have been like, that's not divine purpose.
That is not.
Bottom. We asked, what do you think the most important principles a good wife should have?
Mm.
And 43% said service to God.
Okay.
And 25% said tending to the needs of her husband. And get this, third was achieving personal career goals. That's when you said divine purpose. When you said career goals.
Okay. My divine purpose is to God and my man.
They're like, okay. You don't want to hear about your career goals.
They don't want to hear about us modern women.
I have to get home to my man.
Yes, I cannot.
And cater to him.
Come into work. I have children to feed.
Yep.
Backs to lay on.
Yes. Here for these career goals. And the last two were actually cooking and cleaning and maintaining good looks got 0% of a quality that a good wife should have.
I am surprised.
Each week, to move the conversation forward, we'll share discussions that are happening elsewhere on this very topic. For instance, Brooke Obi, in an article on The Root, said it's basically time for men to stop telling women what they need to do to be worthy of marriage. And Nikki McGloster actually had one of our favorite headlines in a piece she wrote on The Grill where she said, "Sorry, Sierra, telling single women to get filled with the pick-me spirit is for the birds."
That part.
Again.
Oh,
and as Kiara mentioned earlier, we actually sat down with Pastor John Gray to get some more info on this topic and answer the question, what is the spirit of girlfriend? So here's what he had to say.
I wanted to touch on a little bit of this viral clip that went everywhere, all over Facebook and Twitter, which was the spirit of girlfriend. Mm-hmm. And I know that in your sermon you said, you know, you're a wife when I find you. Okay, so I wanted to just kind of give you space to clarify that.
And so the premise is that the character of a woman should go before the title that she gets. Even in the New Testament, when the Bible talks about the establishment of the church, it talks about deacons. That word diakoneo means servant. And what the scripture connotates is that you were already serving when I choose you. And so in the same spirit, you're a wife, not because I give you a ring, because there are many women who have a ring but don't have the character of a Proverbs 31 woman. There are men who get married that don't have the heart of a husband. And so the premise, and this is where things kind of got dicey, is we're in a post-feminism moment. We're like, hey, we're independent. We don't need marriage. That does not define us. And so it was important for me to clarify that this was from a construct of a Christian-centric thought about relationships. So it does not apply to everyone. It only applies to the people that are saying, this is something I subscribe to.
So is a married woman more successful than a single woman? Or is a woman not truly successful until she finds her husband? Hell no. I think it's safe to say success is subjective, and it's up to you to decide what spirit you want to walk in. Homegirl, walk in your own spirit.
Yes.
All right. Thanks for watching Listen to Black Women, and be sure to follow us, tweet us, and join us on next week's poll. And always remember, AKA never forget, listen to Black Women.